everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to do two quick and easy hairstyles for really long hair on Sophie today. So we're going to get started. So first I'm going to show you how to do a fishtail plait on the side. And this is quite a simple one, but it's like hard to master once you've got it. So it's going to be quite relaxed, it's not going to be quite tight, it's going to be quite loose to the side. So first you want to section your hair into two halves, like this, in equal sections. Then you're going to take about an inch worth of hair from the back section. Can I just get you to turn around? Mm-hmm. Like that, and then cross it over to the first section, making sure you still have the two equal sections. And then basically, you hold that there, take this section and cross it over. So basically, you're just taking the two pieces from the back of equal sizes and crossing them over into the next section. And let's just stop there. Yeah, you just basically, and can you see how it's like forming a join in the middle? And it looks really nice with the ombre when you start getting to that bit, because you can really see the colour changes. Yeah, I'm going to keep crisscrossing. And make sure not to turn it into a plait, because I've done that sometimes. You know when you do it so quick, and then you have the free, and then you just automatically have three sections? Or have you never done that?
I've never done that.
Oh, I've done it for. So just make sure you always know what side they're going on. And this has become quite a thick one, but for the messy, it doesn't matter too much.
At the end, you always can pull it apart or anything.
Yeah, I'll show you some ways of how to
do it. It really all depends what kind of day you're having and
depends how much time you have.
Yeah.
But it's easy, as long as you take the sections from the back, like this, cross it over. So now, as you can see, we're on the blonde bits of her hair. And we just... that we're going into the ombre, and you can see the really colour change. Then I'm going to take a clear elastic that you can find anywhere. I got these from Primark in a pack of like 400.
Yeah.
Have it. I'm just going to take you on a full view of the hair from the back. It's from the back, as you can see, it gets thicker, and I mean there is bits spurting out, but that is absolutely fine if you want it messy. Here it comes thick, and as you go down, it's kind of equal, and then you can start seeing the blonde coming through like here, and then it keeps going down, and then you see the colours integrating. As a whole, I think it's just a really nice look. And you can... So now, once you have your completed fishtail plait, you can just pull the sections out to make it seem a bit more puffy. I mean, I know sometimes I do it because I have quite short hair. It's longer now, but when I had short hair, I pulled it out to make it look a bit longer,
you can
thicker.
Also like pull out side bits and whatnot, frame your face and
just poof this up a bit.
Yeah.
Add more volume. I mean, the opportunities are endless and it's so easy. And this probably took how long?
Not that long. It just took long because we were filming, obviously.
Yeah.
So yeah.
So that was the fishtail. Now I'm going to show you how to do the donut bun, which is more of an elegant look, or yeah, it can be a scruffy look if you like have it loose on the back of your head. But for this one, I'm going to show you a more tight up to bun. So let's get started on this one. So for this one, you're going to need a donut. This is blonde, but it's fine because you won't be able to see it. A hairband, which is just a long one, but I'm going to double that up. And then you will need some bobby pins, like this. If you can see that, just normal bobby pins. And then you will also need, I've got a text coming through, I'm so glad that's on silent. And then you will also need the open bobby pins, I think they're called.
I'm not sure.
Just like bun pins that I know a lot of dancers will use for their buns, and they just look like crocodile mouths. So let's get started on this one. Right, so first I'm just going to brush out her hair, which I have done a minute ago, but just to make sure all the tangles are out. And then I know when a lot of people do this, they actually curl the hair before to give it a bit more volume, but I honestly don't think you need to waste the heat on this hairstyle, because it doesn't really make any difference, because you can create the volume yourself without curling it. I'm just going to go for the crown area, so it's high but not too high, because Sophie's got a lot of hair and it will be very heavy on her head. So first I'm just going to bring all the hair back. Oh, bloody all of it. 100 metres long. Now I'm just going to scoop it up. And this is going to be messy, but I'll neaten it up in a minute. To the crown area. As you can see, it's all puffy here. And that's not what we want for a neat pull back. This is kind of like a Kardashian kind of bun, because I know how they have their hair like this. And if your hair just is, because Sophie's moles, I don't know if that's the right word, like Sophie's hair just goes into any hairstyle, if your hair is quite flimsy or broken and it just doesn't work and it doesn't go slick like this, then you'll need a lot of gel or hairspray, because my hair never holds in anything.
Mine doesn't normally.
So I'm just going to scoop it up, and then just to the crown. For the donut ring, just so it doesn't sit flat, just by backcombing it, and it's not a lot. If you're worried about backcombing your hair, you can skip this part, but I just like to do it just for a bit of volume, so it's sorry about that, Sophie. Just so it's a bit higher and sits, and it will last much longer if you back comb just the centre of your hair. You haven't got to do all of it. So now I'm just going to grab my donut, and this is what you'll mean when you see that you don't need it in any specific colour, like brown would be better, but I'm gonna basically just let it fall all around her hair. So now that it's covering her hair, now I've zoomed in, I'm just going to then take the hair and make sure it's sitted around the donut like that, so when you come to putting it round, it goes nice and smooth. So I'm just going to create a gap at the back of the hair like that, and then take one side and then cup it under the donut ring. That is correct, that was the word I'm looking for. Now I know a lot of people all do their donuts differently. I mean, this might not work for Sophie because she has really long hair, so you're gonna have to keep wrapping it. And I know I've showed some other people this technique and they like it or they don't, but yeah, it's gonna look a lot thicker on Sophie because she has a lot more hair. But oh sorry, was there a bit out?
Yeah, I was flapping around.
So now that I have it in a secure position, I'm just gonna, as you can see, there's the blonde bits out the back here, so I'm just gonna first take that and clip it into the hair. And the clipping bit literally takes like 10 seconds, it's so easy. This is my literally go-to hairstyle for when I'm on holiday. Oh, travelling. So then I'm just going to pin it. Oh, and it's not going in. And the pinning is the most important part, because if you use these, it doesn't work as well as if you use these ones. Trust me, I've known from experience. So I'm so old. And that's the only thing I hate about blackberries, when they flash. So annoying. And I'm just going to clip it in, and obviously Sophie has got a lot of hair, my donut is too small for her hair and it's flopping out a bit like a mushroom, but the donuts will sort that out. Oh, it's stuck. So now I'm just going to tidy it up with the clips, and this is the bit that I like because you can really rearrange it all and make it different to how it went, because the clips will secure it under even more than what you did previously. And I'm just going to make sure that I've got every stray hair. So this is the completed look. It's fun. And you can then slick it even more back by just gelling it. Or you can just mess it up a bit by bringing some hair down and framing her face, which always has an elegant touch to it. And some lovely earrings and a nice collar goes with it well. So that's the last quick and easy. I mean, this is a bit more, this looks a bit more, takes a bit longer, but once you've mastered it and know how to do it, it takes me like 3 seconds. So, budge over. So thank you for watching my quick and easy hairstyles of the fish plait and the donut, and we will see you next Saturday.
Bye!